Kind of hard to blow through, but not too bad. My 97 Beauville Chevy van had one of these that were completely clogged. It's not too bad. Bad enough. Fuel filter wasn't too bad, but boy, the stuff that came out of there was nasty. It's not washing off. Alright, got a transmission filter and seal kit. Got 17 bolts. We'll just loosen those all up. Bring them out about halfway and to tip one side down. Stuff in here to clean up with things. Got the spines. Got the 10 millimeter on these. Seems my bearings have shot out of my jack stand's wheel here. See if we can't put those back in later. So, as usual, we've got two troublesome bolts on the transmission pan. And I got the socket stuck. It's pinned in between this transmission mount and the bolt. So, I'm going to pry that out, and then I'm going to use... metal rasp here on the die grinder and make a little channel for the socket so that's easy to take on and off. Wait, look at that big old butterfly moth thing. It's huge. problem getting the socket in there now. Just cut a couple grooves. Pan's coming down, but there's no oil. Come out of there yet. Maybe this pan's big enough to hold all the oil. I don't know. I think it's, I got a feeling it's a little low, though. And it's, you hear it sloshing around in there. I guess we could maybe take this down without having to spill it out one corner. So I could probably just hold that like that, get the bolts out and... Alright, just got three bolts left, two in the back, which are... pretty loose, hanging down about a 3/8 of an inch, and just one in the front. I'm gonna try and tip and get some of the oil out before taking the whole thing down. Just see what happens. I feel like there should be a lot more oil in this. Okay. Whew. We did it. Well, that went nice. Go away, Bumblebee. You don't want to have any of this in your mouth. Filter. Transmission. Check out this magnet. Let's see how dirty that is. Oh yes. So we'll wipe that off, put it back in, and So make sure to wipe this off the rag really good. Got that metal sledge off of there. Put it back in. All right, looks like the filter just kind of wiggles out on this one. No bolt. Oops. Wasn't expecting that. Crap. Yeah. Let's get the cover down. And the new filter. Does that come off? Check and make sure there's a seal in there. Looks like there. That's what that slides into. It took a little prying, and it's finally coming out. There we go. Alright. So now I can kind of feel in there, so make sure it's okay. Yep. Alright, there we go. Just like a little slip ring or something. Soft to tap that in with. I'll probably just put a piece of wood on that and tap the wood. Alright, that worked. Worked out pretty good. And there, good flush. Yeah, that worked out. Okay, new filter in here. Okay, a little more back and forth wiggling. Got that to pop in all the way. So now we are good to put that pan back on. New seal and tighten it down. I'll wipe this off first. Get all the gunk off that rim. Alright, pan is back on. Got the bolts torqued down to 80 inch pounds. I don't know what it's supposed to be, but 80 felt about right. Kinda, maybe a little too tight for this rubber gasket. Squeezing out just a little bit, but that might just also be how it's sitting. Either way, it felt good enough, 80 inch pounds. Now I can put some oil back in it. Thank you. That's something I haven't seen before. A little foamy. What does that mean? Moisture? Heat?
About 5 quarts.